Thank you very much for Hưng Yun Abeka to invite me here. It's my first time to visit KAIST. Yeah. So in this case, I will talk about somehow relation between dynamical system and geometric group theory. So here is the outline of my talk. So I will mention a real focus on the first part, and the second part is somehow the idea is similar in the first part, but we need to handle more technique. So the first part is how about continuous orbit equivalence, cycle superrigidity, and one-end groups. And the second is also another notation in geometric group theory, divergence and distortion, and we replace, we add more condition on Hunde continuous cycle rigidity. So now, before mention about continuous setting, we come back to the history. At the beginning, people focus on measurable setting first. So orbit equivalence, a measurable setting. So now, in the first part of my talk, all of the groups I consider are countable groups. So I consider is a measure resolving action of G act on a robability space X mu, and another robability measure resolving actions of H on robability space Y nu. So normally when we deal with every object, we would like to classify they will be the same or not. Example, two vector space, they are the same or not. And we consider how about cardinality there. We would like to look for some invariant to classify the object there. So in here, also similar situation. For two systems, we would like to know it will be the same or not. So the first, a very strong notation, we said a conjugacy. This means we said that two systems conjugate if there are some isomorphism between them. So the meaning here is you have a diagram X mu here. So X mu. So the action there, so you have Y nu. So phi. And the action here you have chi and h, so you have phi, and then you will have exactly phi gx. So the diagram will commute. Phi gx will be pro g phi x. You have an h here, so pro h, pro g. So that a diagram commute. So in this case, two systems will be the same. If it looks like h and g are the same, and after conjugacy, they are the same. So another weaker notation, this means this will be orbit equivalent. So this means it will send one orbit to another orbit. So this means you consider the orbit in here. So for x, then you consider the orbit. So the orbit in here x, so the orbit of the point x, gx. So normally in dynamical system, we would like to understand the orbit. Yeah. So the orbit in here, so it will be another orbit, so phi x. So it will be phi x in here. So the orbit of phi x in here, see for the space x, here y x, here the space y, you have phi x. Here for the space y. So phi x, so it will be maybe move around here, but it keep the orbit. The orbit, it will go to some position h phi x. So this means this will send one orbit of the x system to the orbit of the y system here. So this means it, so we said orbit equivalent, this means it send the orbit, one orbit in x in here to corresponding orbit in y.
What is usually
new? Measure new is a robbery measure there. So I consider the measure in the robability space. Yeah. Yeah, the measure.
In the conjugate, there is no condition for mu mu.
Let's see, because here I can say, the by measure, by injective measure resolving method here. So this is the condition, is you can say the isomorphism of measure space. So this means we will send, this is a bijection measure resolving in here. Yeah, when we say this is two measurable systems are the same. So this means this keep the structure when you send, so the, it will reserve the measure under the map. Yeah. Measure reserving already. Yeah. So all the equivalent, you see that is clear. So before that I mentioned, I see another notation we said W star equivalent. This means W star, this means von Neumann algebra. In the past, they we say C star algebra, W star algebra. This means W star, this means von Neumann algebra equivalent. If there is a von Neumann algebra isomorphism of the cross product. So I skip the detail because we need time to explain the definition here, but it's not important. So just mention, this means there is somehow isomorphism between von Neumann algebra level. So of cross product von Neumann algebra. So we consider von Neumann algebra as non-commutative probability space, yeah, measurable space. Yeah. So then it's clearly that conjugacy will imply orbit equivalence because in this case it's stronger than orbit equivalence. And if two systems are essentially probability measure reserving, then orbit equivalence will imply that W star equivalence. So in general we have so the name, meaning essential free, this means it always, if the element trees is different around the identity, it always move. Yeah, you don't fix x normally. Most of the point, it will be moved under the action. So normally, in general, you will have conjugacy imply orbit equivalent. And imply that it's imply W star equivalent. In general, you have that. So the meaning of rigidity. So and here, see, before that, I mentioned that if two systems here measure reserving, then it's the orbit equivalent. If only if there exists a von Neumann algebra and it reserves the Kaktang subalgebra. This means the abelian subalgebra inside here. So this means it is W star equivalent and it reserves the Kaktang subalgebra. It's by Isidore Singer long time ago. So we have a standard thing in here. So normally we would like to know, do we have the converse? In every place, do we have the converse? So this means W star equivalent must be exactly as orbit equivalent, and orbit equivalence must be exactly as conjugacy. You have no other choice.
Your definition about the W equivalence requires the action to be free, right?
Yes, so normally
the premise is not that important, and you can always achieve free.
Normally we have we handle with many examples essential of free. It's not the
Not a big requirement because you are assuming that it's almost every free.
Yeah. That's because normally we deal with many examples with essentially free. Yeah. Example the full ship, everything, yeah, essentially free. Yeah. So in here, so we would like to know, we see whether it have the converse. That's the meaning of rigidity. You have no other choice. So orbit equivalence, super rigidity, this means orbit equivalence will imply exactly conjugacy. You have the only choice there. So it's a well-known result by Ornstein, Weiss, and Kohn's, Feynman, Weiss in 80s. So this means for any two non-atomic measure reserving ergodic actions, of amenable groups, they are all of equivalent. So this means, this is at the beginning by days, days the proof that in for any non-atomic measure resolving ergodic action of Z actions, so Z group is on only of equivalent. But after that, we can handle that is the only choose for every amenable group actions there. So very powerful result. So now this is a basic example for measure resolving and essentially free. This means we say that a shape, yeah, the full shape, Bernoulli shape. So here we consider A is a finite set. So then you can see the shape action there on the shape, the full shape. So we take the action for this mean A G in here will be the product, yeah, G and will be so you can see the X G to A, and you see so this means you act on there. H will be on the left. Of course, you also have on the right. Yeah. So it move. If you draw the picture, we take the value on the left. Yeah. So we see a left Bernoulli shape. Yeah. Now you see, you can check. Let's see. It will be essentially free in here. Yeah. So. Then another well-known result by Ornstein and Weiss. This means if you can see the amenable groups, then two Bernoulli shape are conjugate if and only if they have the same Kolmogorov entropy. So this means they are conjugacy if and only if they have the same entropy. So this means for you see that. This result and this result see that is in general data they are not of equivalent rigidity because we have a lot of ordinary here see of equivalent but they are not conjugacy. So that's the reason when people focus on of equivalent rigidity, we focus on non-amenable groups because for amenable groups it definitely. Of equivalence rigidity. So here's about some result about measurable of equivalence. So this is first by Robert Zimmer on his very well-known result. It's a very special case. He mentioned his result for more strong form. Here I only mention a very special case of his result. This means the natural actions of SL and Z on the at the end toroid, they are all non-op equivalent. See SL and Z in here see definitely is not amenable. So for his method, he used the idea term this means he used cocycle superrigidity. He proved that cocycle superrigidity, then it will imply, I will mention the definition of cocycle superrigidity later. It will always imply equivalence superrigidity. And recently, not much recently, 10 years ago, using somehow the idea in von Neumann algebra, so many other rigidity results for measurable of equivalent, so can be done for a large class of non-amenable groups, normally related with property T, so related with Cac d'Ang property T. So here I mentioned a special case again here because he also. Can do for more general system, but for simple, I only mentioned his special case for the full shape. And also a special case in here, just consider for the product group, but of course his result can apply for more general groups related with property T. So here I consider a direct product of infinite group H and a non-amenable group K. Then the full shift action in here is always measurable cycle superrigidity for every finite set A. So this means Bernoulli shift is super rigid in here. Yeah. Cycle super rigid. And here you find this means somehow it's a polished group arising as closed subgroups of the unitary groups of finite volume on algebra. The important point here, this means you find H in U phi, then H is admitted by invariant magic. By invariant matrix, this means this is D of GH, GH prime will be D of H, H prime equal D of H, G, H prime. H prime G for any G, H, G prime in G. So this is on the left and on the right also reserve the matrix. Yeah, and here's the by invariant matrix. So now we come to continuous setting. So in our subject, we would like to have some result similar as result of Zimmer and Popper. So and I focus on continuous setting. So again, so now we have two continuous action on a topological space X and Y. So again, we also the first very strong classification. This means equal conjugacy again. So two system of conjugacy, if you have an isomorphism between two system. And similarly, we also have continuous orbit equivalent. So continuous orbit equivalent, this means in this case, you also have it keep the orbit. But the way you reparametrize here, you also need it is continuous. This is somehow the definition absolutely is too strong because you require it's really continuous sense. So this means the idea in here means you have gx in here. So x again. So gx. So now also again you will have it will be phi x. So phi x. So you have, it will move in here, so maybe in here phi of gx. So maybe here gx. So we'll have the value as in here will be some h of phi x. And h in here, it depends on g and on x. The value h in here, h in the group h, it depends on g and x. So you weigh in here, depend on g and x. The value of h in here depend on g and x. Similarly, the value of c, h and y in here also depends on h and y. So, but we also need the condition that the way we choose here is continuous. So it is the way we choose in here is continuous. And previous definition we have is topological orbit equivalent. This means we only need the condition phi is homomorphism and B and C, maybe it's the discontinuous in several places. It's also okay. Yeah, it's a weaker notation for orbit equivalence by Giordano, Matui, Putnam, and Skull. So then, again, it's for essentially free in topological setting, we also have a condition about topological free. So then, if two systems are topological free action, then two systems are continuous or equivalent, so similar as the result of a single. So it's a C star or isomorphism, and it reserves the Kaktang subalgebra. So similar result as single orbit, continuous orbit equivalent if it is C star isomorphism between reduced Rost product C star algebra, and it reserves the Kaktang subalgebra. So again, it is topological free. This means for any G different from the identity, it always move. Yeah, so the different the non-fixed point is dense in X. Yeah, that's a standard assumption. So it's not difficult to check that if the system near G, the action is topological free, then the math in here is unique, determined by this condition, because using the topological free, then it is unique, determined by this condition, the second condition. So this means the way we choose C, H, Y there is uniquely determined. And furthermore, it will satisfy co-cycle condition. So far, I haven't defined a definition of co-cycle. That's the meaning of co-cycle. So this means the meaning of co-cycle here, this means for the system, you have G act on X. So then you have the meaning of co-cycle, this means GX in here. Math. Of course, it depends. You can consider a continuous, measurable, it depends on your setting, yeah. If it is continuous, then it is continuous, and it is defined everywhere and measurable, then you see the condition is here for measurable setting, if it is defined in the full measure. So the meaning here, you go in here X, you go to G1, G2, X. Another way here, so you go G2X. So I also go in here G1. So the way we reparametrize, they have the same value. After reparametrize, you also go back to the same value. So that's the standard definition for co-cycle. So it's also similar measurable setting. Conjugacy implies continuous orbit equivalent. So we also ask again, when do we have the converse? So this means here somehow the theorem by Sinley. So this means if the roof G is torsion free and amenable, and two systems are topological free, then they are orbit equivalent. So if the action is co-cycle rigid, then two systems is conjugacy. So that's the principle idea by Zimmer. If two systems are equivalent and you have co-cycle rigidity, so normally you have the orbit equivalent. So G act on X orbit equivalent to H on Y. And normally you would like to ask their conjugacy or not. So we would like to know whether in here will be conjugacy or not. So normally you add more condition, it is on here, it's the co-cycle rigid. So H co-cycle rigid, super rigid, so rigid, yeah. normally we imply that. So that's the idea. So if you are equivalent and the cocycle retreat, then it will imply
that's the H cocycle condition.
Yeah. And that are the condition for cocycle, but it's not the meaning of retreat. Yeah, so the meaning of retreat is it has the is here. So I will define. The meaning of retreat is here, so you can twist it with some homomorphism. The meaning here, because you can check it easily, this will be a cocycle. This is a standard cocycle. And if the cocycle can be twist by the transfer map here and homomorphism, then we say that it retreat. So it looks like the same as homomorphism. So this is mean it does not here depends on the value of x. And here after you twist, it does not depend on the value of x. So the meaning of cocycle, this means after you can have a transfer map. This means you twist between here, then it does not depend on x. Yeah. So if you multiply in here, then you see that it will be a homomorphism. So it does not depend on x. Yeah. So the meaning of retreat, this means every cocycle, this must be, so it will be a trivial cocycle here. We call it a trivial cocycle. So we say that a system is super retreat if it is always continuous H cocycle retreat for every discrete group H, very strong condition there. So here some example. So why in here we say that it is not correct when Z, G equals Z. So now the relation be, so how geometric group theory come from in here, yeah, to the rigidity. So at the beginning, we figure out the why is in here the idea is in general, it's not super rigid cocycle. Example for the KG equals Z. So in here, we can see the system G equals Z. And here A equals generally two elements, so 0 and 1, in the root cocycle there. So now I can see so G the generator of G, of Z in this case. So I can see that the value will be the value of X cheese. So X belongs to here. Then C of GX will be the so it will be exactly X1. So you can see the G in here 1, then it will be X1. So it's the one coordinate value of X. So then in this system you have two spectral points. So X in here will be on a 0. So it is 0, 0, and any place. And X, another X in here, 1 for any position. So you have a fixed point here, fixed point of the system. So then you will see that if it is trivial, this means there is some map, transfer map B, and a homomorphism group phi from Z to Z over 2Z. Then it must satisfy this condition, but because it's a fixed point, so the value here cancel. Because gx will be always x, a fixed point. So you will have gx will be x, fixed point. Then you will see that the value in here you have two choice. So in here will be 0 and 1 because we choose two different point p, point x. So you get contradiction here. So because here it has two value, has two different value at G. So that's a for example for G equals Z. Similarly, when G is a free group with R generators, then we also can construct a similar example. So because in here for free groups we have no relation at all for the generators. So we only need to define the definition of cocycle only on finite on the generators, because no relation at all, so you can multiply after that. Yeah, using the condition of multiplication of cocycle. So again, we also can check that in this case, it is not trivial. So this means in this case, it's not trivial. So this means now we get a surprising result. So this means we can prove that it depends on the property of rigidity. It depends heavily on the geometric property of the loop. So this means if G has one end, then every full shape is super rigid. This means if the loop has one end, it's very powerful, really orbit equivalent rigidity. Yeah. So the idea in there, so I will explain the idea of, and then we give a equivalent, so this means it is also equivalent. Every full shape is super rigid, then it's a so we give a new characterization, so G has one end. Yeah, I will explain it now. Yeah, it's the one end, if and only if, yeah, G in here a super rigid, cocycle super rigid. Of course, from the example, you see that Z and free group are definitely not one end group. Yeah. The other way is very easy to check. It's if a cocycle super rigid, then it's one end. It's easy to check. We generally use another characterization by Hilton using homology. But you see, the most difficult is that way. I will explain the idea why we think about one end later. Because we follow the idea of a Popper and how to translate. Because normally we would like to translate measurable setting to topological setting. We need to understand which corresponding definition we should use. So this means applying this cocycle super rigidity, then we have orbit equivalent super rigid. So this means if amenable loop torsion free there, and if another system, topological free system, is all equivalent to the full shape here, so they are must be exactly conjugacy. So this means if they are not conjugacy system with the full shape, they are definitely all equivalent to the full shape. So this means we apply this result to continuous orbit equivalent, similar in the sense of Zimmer. Get the super rigidity result on cocycle and apply to orbit equivalent rigidity. And then our result also hold for more general than full shape. But for the simple, I honestly mentioned the full shape. And indeed, I also can generalize for more system, but we need to handle more technique. So I don't mention on more techniques. They only mention very special case first. And furthermore, because for the application, continuous orbit equivalent, I need the condition H is discrete countable loop. But for cocycle superrigidity, normally I would like to get the value of the cocycle not just only on here, it's maybe general topological group. So more recently, I also would like to apply furthermore for different or the Lie roof. So that is the other works. We need to add more ingredients there. But for application in continuous orbit equivalent, we only focus on countable discrete group. Yes, I mentioned this means a new characterization of one-end loop. This means it's a necessary condition. One-end is a necessary condition. So here is the definition of one-end loop. So now we start from a graph. So we say that the number E gamma of the graph is less or equal than n. If you consider any finite collection of the graph, H here, the complement have at most infinite kinetic components. So after you count, it has only at most and infinite kinetic components. And we say that this will be the end of the graph, will be m, will be the smallest integer satisfy that condition. And if no smallest integer there, we say that is the end of the graph is infinity. So normally we would like to understand the asymptotic property of the graph when we take a large possible and we cut down and we count how many kinetic component left. So that's the geometric group theory. So this means now consider finally generated group. So I consider Kelly graph here. So I also then this is then you can see that the number of n of the graph does not depend on the choice of the generating set. So that we call this is the n of the groups. Yeah. So we would like to understand the asymptotic how many kinetic component after we take the complement as so you see for any countable group finally generated group there are generally four choice. So it is generally with 0n, 1n, 2n or infinity n. You don't have other choice. So of course 0 it is generally finite. So because if you take it is large enough, then no kinetic component left. And it is 2, if it is, and then so you see that z here after you cut, it always have two kinetic component. So two, so the number of n of the two in the case z is 2. And it's a well-known result by Stoneling's n theorem. So the number, the n of the roof is infinity if g can be written as a free product amalgamation a star cb here or a hnn extension. So it is infinity if and only if it has this well-known result by Stoneling's. So the other case is that so you see that we only have three other choice. So this is the other example, it would be 1n group. So the idea in here, so you see that z and for in here z square. So you see that if you cut the bar, see the grid here, the Kelly graph, after you cut, it's generally one kinetic component for z square. So the end of the z here is 1. Because when you cut out here, so we have only one kinetic component. And for the free group, so F2 here, so you go down and of course infinity, and then you cut, you see that we have infinite kinetic component. So that is the end of free group here, infinite. Because after you cut here, you go down, you have infinite kinetic component. So the end of free group in here is the infinite. Yeah. So that's the reason and here we go down more. Yeah. Infinite kinetic component. So that's the reason the example when z and fr is done is not correct. Yeah, because it's infinite. Z is 2n and free group is infinite n. And this is theorem here is we have every amino group that is not but totally z, this has it must have 1n. If a non-amenable group g has 0 first L2 Betti number, then it has 1n. So I explain why we consider 1n here, because in this Popper result, so this means whenever g satisfy measurable cocycle superrigidity, if only if the non-amenable group G has zero first L2 Betti number. We know that is a necessary condition. This means if a measurable cocycle superrigidity, then it must have zero first L2 Betti number. But For the sufficient condition, also still open. Yeah. We don't know if the zero first L2 Betti number is enough to get the measurable super co-cycle super rigidity. So that's the reason we consider how we figure out the idea why we consider the number of n in our result. So here is somehow the outline of the roof, so I will mention only briefly. So normally here is the idea why we focus on there. So I just write down how about measurable setting and how about continuous co-cycle. Measurable co-cycle and here continuous co-cycle. So here by Popa, here's by me and Chang. So basic Chatterjee. So we will pass to the product. Also here, definitely we also pass to somehow we use some equivalent relation there. So that's the, we follow the idea of Popa and Robert T. Of G on X. So in that he used malleable deformation and here we use specification here's the measure mixing mixing is important condition we need to use. So here we use topological mixing. And property of G. And here is Kakdang. Property T. Here is one N. So that's how we mimic the method by Popa and we figure out which suitable for continuous setting. So briefly, normally we need to find the solution there. So we need to find a good direction such that we get a solution for one direction first. And how from that direction, solution from that direction, we would like to extend on the solution for on group G. So normally that's the way Zimmer, and for we said that is Zimmer problem, we would like to find good direction first. How to get solution in very special direction first. And after that, we find the universal solution later. Yeah. So that's the idea, we need more property. Then after find one direction and use the property specification and one day any group, then we can get the universal solution. And the idea after that, so see when we have a solution in a small group, then we can extend to the bigger group. So we have solution from G0, then after that we can take the solution for all normalizer. That's the technique how to extend the solution from one direction to a universal solution. So now I come to the second part of my talk. See about Hunder continuous co-cycle rigidity. So another story from there, so not from von Neumann algebra stuff or from Popa problem, but now I focus on more on smooth dynamics. So for smooth dynamics in here, so Katok and Spazier, so they prove that it's a super rigidity for anisotropic actions. So normally we consider for smooth dynamics, so how about diffeomorphism action on the manifold. So they established the result for higher rank abelian groups. So it means for any hyperbolic actions, then for certain standard higher rank abelian group action, they only have Hondr continuous cocycle is Hondr cohomogeneous to a constant cocycle without any assumption on periodic data. So because normally from the Lipschitz theory, for this mean you always need a condition from the orbit data. So that's a standard result in anisotropic diffeomorphism. You need the periodic data for Z action. But the difference here, for higher rank, we don't need any assumption on periodic data, as I explained in the previous part. So it's not generally because the higher rank, but because it's from the end of the group. So this means here they use the higher rank, but the heuristic idea behind this means because we have one end, we can glue it together. If we avoid some bone, then we can glue it together. Yeah, that's the idea. So now I consider how to generalize this result of Katok and Spazier, how to generalize their result. So I start from very basic form. First is ship. So for ship is a very special case because we consider a zero dimension case of anisotropic action there. Because normally for anisotropic action you consider for manifold. But in here you consider a hyperbolic. I consider a very special case because if you would like to replace ZK by generalized group, you cannot start jump directly how to show there, but I focus on very special case first. Very special system here. Then I would like to ask, is a Hondr cohomogeneous for any topological complete group H admitting by invariant matrix. So this means the targeting value group here, it's not just only countable group, this is a general topological group. But in our result, I also need this also strong condition. This condition, this means I cannot apply directly to diffeomorphism M or Lie group. That condition is quite strong. So it's by invariant matrix. So in our method, it's also disadvantage because we cannot replace this to get. You see, if you can apply this to more general groups here, then you can have more application in study smooth dynamics. But this is now for simple. I only focus on by invariant matrix first for simple case. So first. Of course, now we have the condition Hondr continuous, and it's a HE topological group, so I need to add more condition. So the first, I consider we set it on distorted elements. So this means I would like to measure how about the translation number there. So I use somehow work land metric there. When you fix a finally generated set S, then I can have the land metric, work land metric. So then if you consider for an element of infinite order and you would like to measure there, then we will satisfy the subadditive condition. So if you work on entropy or geometric group theory, normally if you have function satisfying subadditive condition, then you can define the limit easily. So the limit there will be the infimum there because it satisfies subadditive condition. So we said that the translation number will be this limit. So you would like to measure how about the growth of the length when is the n go to infinity? We said that a distortion element if the translation number is non-zero. So non-zero if, not if, if it is true for L for some finitely generating set, then it's definitely true for own finitely generating set. So we said that the group here certifying property undistortion if there's some at least one element is undistorted. So a lot of group, definitely you see that is a lot of group certify this condition. It's very mild condition because you see that normally the speed, the length of the, when you take the exponential the exponential growth of the length metric there, it definitely normally it goes fast. Yeah. So now to deal with Honda continuous cycle, I also need one more thing. So I say that the sub-exponential divergence. So here the idea of the divergence. So defined by Gaston. Yeah, Gaston. Gaston, mainly by Gaston. Maybe in Utah, yeah. Gaston about divergence. And here, if I consider two point AB, so normally consider how to avoid. For some C here, I need to know how to avoid the bone. And here I would like to consider the smallest path. I measure the smallest path such that it avoids the bone. If you see the roof, I use one end roof for the previous part. Then that's the way how I avoid the bone. So in here, the idea, we also use the same. For Honda continuous cycle, we also need to avoid the bone in without pay much on the price, how much the price I avoid the bone. So this means the divergence here, I would like to know the minimum length I need to go to avoid own bone like that. So somehow a little technique condition there. So this means I would like to, normally it's the general idea, this means how to measure for to avoid the bone between any two point A, B there. So I would like to know the maximum value when I avoid the bone. So we said I draw sub-exponential if the way I avoid the bone here, the path does not go much, very far. Yeah, so somehow the length of the path I need to avoid the bone, normally it's probably less than exponential growth. So not go so fast, then I can avoid the bone. So then after that, add more condition there. So undistorted element and sub-exponential divergence, then every Honda continuous cycle is also super rigid. So that is the technique condition I add. This is a very mild condition. This is a condition somehow a little rigid. But not also contain most of the rigidity group I would like to focus. Because when we deal with rigidity result, normally we focus on uniformly lattice in simple, semi-simple, higher Rangley group, and we also on Thompson groups and mapping class group. This is you work on rigidity. Of course, many rigidity things. It depends on what kind of rigidity you work. So here I just list some examples, certify own condition there. So some basic example certify that condition. So this means it will be super rigid in this case. But I mentioned my goal is that I would like to extend the result of Kartoff and Spazier, not generally for the ship. Ship is a very special case. But because if you would like to handle with manifold here, you need to handle many things. Not just only for the ship. The ship very easy because here is a zero dimensional case. So to handle in this case, we need to more ingredient, and we need to add more condition on CoCycle. So I also haven't finished yet, but I guess some partial result for how to understand, I would say how to understand the result when we replace higher rank abelian group to one end group, and which how to get that result. And furthermore, because in this case, I use the idea of the previous result on when we consider one end group, but is it not? Is it a sufficient condition? But is it not necessary condition? The previous result in the part one is a necessary and sufficient condition. But in here, it's generally sufficient condition. I have another roof to get similar the statement result here, but contains on other result. So it also contains on certain hyperbolic one end roof. Yeah. But I use different method. This method somehow also some disadvantage. Okay, I think I should stop my talk here. Yeah.